हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स डीजे गणित। सो इन दिस लेक्चर नंबर 30 वी आर गोइंग टू डू वन मोर प्रॉब्लम यूजिंग पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस प्रॉब्लम। हियर वी आर आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट वैल्यू ऑफ दिस डबल इंटीग्रल ई टू द पावर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर ओवर द रीजियन आर, वेयर आर इज द सेमी सर्क्युलर रीजियन। सेमी सर्क्युलर मीन्स हाफ ऑफ द सर्कल, बाउंडेड बाय द एक्स एक्सिस एंड द कर्व वाई इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर। सो एक्स एक्सिस मीन्स वाई इक्वल टू जीरो एंड दिस इज द सर्कल विथ सेंटर जीरो जीरो एंड रेडियस वन। सो गिवन कर्व्स आर एक्स एक्सिस दैट इज वाई इक्वल टू जीरो एंड वाई इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर, दैट वी कैन री राइट एज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर इक्वल टू वन। सो फर्स्ट वी स्केच द सर्कल एंड देन वी डिसाइड द रीजन ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन। सो सपोज दिस इज वाई एक्सिस एंड से दिस इज एक्स एक्सिस। सो वी हैव टू स्केच द सर्कल विथ सेंटर जीरो जीरो एंड रेडियस वन। सो वी जस्ट ट्राई टू स्केच द सर्कल रफली, इट शुड लुक लाइक ए सर्कल। So suppose we consider that this is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius 1. So this is the center of the circle. This is x axis means y equal to 0. Circle has equation x square plus y square equal to 1. And we have to consider the semicircular region bounded by x axis and the curve y equal to square root of 1 minus x square. So here we have two semicircular regions. This is upper semicircular region and this is lower semicircular region. Now if we consider this equation x square plus y square equal to 1, then we can rewrite x square plus y square equal to 1 as y square equal to 1 minus x square. Therefore, y equal to plus or minus under root 1 minus x square. So, if we consider this upper semicircular region, here we have y equal to positive square root of 1 minus x square and here we have negative square root of 1 minus x square. And in our question, our R is the semicircular region bounded by x axis and the curve y equal to positive square root of 1 minus x square. So we will consider upper semicircular region. If we were given y equal to negative of square root of 1 minus x square, then we would have considered this lower semicircular region. But here in our question y is given to be positive square root of 1 minus x square. So we will consider upper semicircular region. So region of integration is upper semicircular region that we indicate by this red lines. So we have to integrate our function over this upper semicircular region indicated by these lines. So it is bounded by x axis, this is x axis and this is this. For this upper semicircular region, value of y is square root of 1 minus x square. Here y is square root of 1 minus x square. In the lower part, y is negative square root of 1 minus x square. This is y axis that we can represent by x equal to 0. Here radius is 1, so this point is 1, 0 and this point is 0, 1. Now, if we want to evaluate this double integral using Cartesian coordinates, then we first have to integrate. Suppose we try to integrate with respect to y first, then we will require value of this integral. So here we can rewrite this as integral of e raised to x square into e raised to y square, and e raised to x square is considered as constant while integrating with respect to y. So we can take it outside. So we require formula for the integral of e raised to y square. If we select integration with respect to y first. But this is not elementary integral. We are not having any formula for the integral of this e to the power y square. So it is not easy to evaluate this double integral in Cartesian coordinates. So we are going to use polar coordinates and we will see how we can easily find out value of double integral using Cartesian coordinates. So we have sketched the region of integration. So we find out the limits of r and theta polar coordinates. So to find out limits of r, we consider a ray starting from origin and passing through the region as shown here. So now at this point, ray enters in the region and this point is at origin. So lower limit for r is 0. So here we write enters at r equal to 0. This point is on the circle x square plus y square equal to 1. And we know that if we consider x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, x square plus y square is 1. So this is nothing but r equal to 1. So at this point, value of r is 1. So upper limit for r is 1. This ray leaves the region at r equal to 1. So now we have to consider this type of rays. So we will start from this point. This point is on x-axis. So at this point, value of theta is 0. And we will consider rays in this direction, in the increasing direction of theta. And we have to go up to this point. At this point, value of theta is pi. So the smallest value of theta is 0. And the largest possible value of theta is pi. So limits of theta are from 0 to pi and limits of r are from 0 to 1. So now once we have the limits of r and theta, we can evaluate this integral by transforming it into polar integral. So to transform into polar integral, first we consider x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, then as we know dy dx is replaced by r times dr d theta. And here we have to mention these things, that to decide the limits of integration, we imagine a ray starting from origin and passing through region R as shown in above figure. So this is the region of integration, upper semicircular region, and we have obtained the limits of integration. Ray enters the region at r equal to 0. Ray leaves the region at r equal to 1. So the limits of integration are r is from 0 to 1. And smallest possible value of theta is 0 and the largest possible value of theta is pi. So theta is from 0 to pi. So now we can find out equivalent polar integral to given Cartesian integral. Given Cartesian integral is e raised to x square plus y square dy dx. So now we consider x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta, so that एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर इज ई रेस टू आर स्क्वायर एंड डी वाई डी एक्स इज रिप्लेस बाय आर डी आर डी थीटा, आर इज फ्रॉम 0 to 1 एंड थीटा इज फ्रॉम 0 to π. सो फर्स्ट इंटीग्रेशन हियर इज ऑलवेज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर. सो वी कंसिडर दिस इनर इंटीग्रल फर्स्ट. हियर वी विल ट्रीट थीटा इज कॉन्स्टेंट. नाउ टू इंटीग्रेट दिस वी कैन एज्यूम आर स्क्वायर इक्वल टू सम अनदर वेरिएबल. सपोज वी टेक आर स्क्वायर इक्वल टू से टी, देन इफ वी डिफरेंशिएट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टी ऑन बोथ साइड्स वी हैव 2R dr by dt equal to 1, so that 2R dr equal to dt. So we will replace R dr by dt by 2, and limits will be same. When R is 0, t is 0. When R is 1, t is 1. So we have theta is from 0 to pi, and here instead of r, now our variable is t. When r is 0, t is 0. When r is 1, t is 1. R square is t, and r dr is 1/2 dt. And then we have to consider integral with respect to theta. Now here 1 by 2 is constant, so that we can take outside both the integrals. Limits are from 0 to pi. Integral of e raised to t is e raised to t. T is from 0 to pi, and then we have to integrate with respect to theta. So now limits of theta are from 0 to pi. We first put t equal to pi, so e raised to pi minus t equal to 0, that is e raised to 0, which is 1 d theta. So here I made a mistake. Limits of r are from 0 to 1, so here I have to write 1. R is from 0 to 1, so here we have e raised to 1, that is e minus 1. Now e minus 1 is constant, so that we can take outside, and integral of d theta from 0 to pi. So this is nothing but e minus 1 by 2. Integral of theta is, integral of 1 with respect to theta is theta, and limits of theta are from 0 to pi. So this is going to be pi minus 0, that is pi. So we have pi by 2 times e minus 1. So this is the value of given double integral. We can see we are able to evaluate this double integral easily by transforming it into polar integral. So this is the benefit of converting Cartesian integral into polar integral. If you are not comfortable to integrate in with respect to Cartesian coordinates, you can try to convert Cartesian coordinates into polar coordinates. And in some cases you will be able to find out value of double integral easily, as in this case. So this is all about this session. I hope you like this lecture. Thank you very much.